All right, all you Adobe users, Coach Kilburn here again with part three of our video series on using Adobe InDesign Creative Cloud to create a sample newsletter. So guys, again, we're just practicing here. If you have not watched the first two videos, go back and watch the first two videos and work along and try to get caught up to this point. All right, guys, at the end of the last video, we created this bucket. Right, we had a big rectangle, a smaller rectangle, a text frame, another text frame, a content frame. We grouped all of those together. Originally, it was on this side of the page. So guys, we group things so we can move them all at once and we don't have to waste time moving them independently. Right, so guys, again, if I click on that, it's all grouped. I come up here to object. Why object? Because everything in InDesign is an object. I can now go to ungroup, right? So why would you ungroup? Well, maybe I want to go in and change the font. Maybe change the font color or size. Maybe mess with that image down there of the football field. So if I ungroup, now that text frame is independently, right? It's independent. I can move it by itself. Right, I'm pretty happy with this bucket, right, for right now. So again, I'm gonna just click and left click and draw a box over all the objects. It will select all the objects at the same time. Then I can come up to object group. Now again, once again, they're grouped together. Guys, don't forget you have all this workspace out here. You're not limited to just the document. You can build and create things out here in your work area and then bring it back. So guys, I'm gonna move this box over. Guys, if you use the arrow keys on the keyboard, it will move about one pixel every time you hit the arrow. If you hold down shift, it moves about 10 pixels, right? One of our students found out that you could go into your preferences, edit, go all the way down here to preferences. Right, they went into their units and increments and they found there's a way to change that. You can lower the pixel to like a half a pixel so it won't move as far, or you can up the pixels. If you want to go in and change the preferences, guys, on any of this stuff, go in and change your preferences. All right, click on it, put this back over here in this column. Again, guys, you can use your arrow keys on the keyboard to kind of nudge things into place. We're going to move this key dates back over here to where it was originally. Guys, the only reason why I moved it was I wanted to show you how to group. Okay. All right, guys, now let's build a couple more buckets, right? So the one we're using as a guide, they got two buckets. They're sort of similar. We can kind of build one bucket, copy and paste it, and then edit that. So we're going to build this bucket here, copy, paste, and then come over here and edit. We do need to do some text wrap on this one. Okay. All right, so let's come back. I'm going to get my rectangle tool. Right, I can go ahead and assign a color if I like. All right, so get in here and change the color, right? Guys, you can use any colors you like. You use the colors that you think work best for your projects. Right? Go something like this. All right, guys, I'm going to use this guide here. Again, I suggest you use your zoom tool, your magnifying glass, and kind of zoom in so things are larger. It'd be easier to see things if they're large. Right? I got to switch these arrows. I got to swap that fill and a stroke. I want that fill, but no stroke. Right now I got this fill. I have a white stroke. I don't need a stroke. Double click on that. Right. Actually, what I'm going to do is I'm going to go down here, guys. So look, this is a solid. This is a gradient. And this is no, none. I don't want a white fill. I mean, I'm sorry. I don't want a white stroke. I don't need that stroke. So I'm going to choose to go no stroke. I have a fill color, and no stroke, right? All right, so I'm gonna click, get on this line, click and drag. Again, I gotta leave a little bit of space. Why? Because design likes space, okay? Remember, design likes space. Boom, got it. All right. Now, I need a little heading up here. So again, I'm going to click off of that. I want to come in here, do another one, a bucket at the top. Guys, if I want to line it up here, I can come up here to my ruler, remember, and I can drag down a guide. Right now, I got a guide and a guide. Drag. Boom. Maybe I want to darken that color. So again, I can double click on that color, right? And I want to add in a little black. K equals black. So let me add in about 30% black. See what that looks like. Boom. All right. I'm happy with that. Okay. Now I need another text box. It says topic 2. So I'm just going to click out. I could just take this one, right? First, I need to ungroup, right? That way I can click just on that text box. I want to copy that and then paste that. Then I can use my arrow keys to move that into place, right? Did you see how quick that moved? That's because I was holding shift down, right? Boom, I'm going to line that up. Now I can just come in here with my type tool, and I can just change that to 2. Boom, nice and quick and easy, guys. Copy and paste and edit. Again, maybe I get this text frame. I copy. I paste. There it is. I nudge it into place, right? Boom, boom, boom. I can resize this text frame, right? Guys, remember, that's overset text. So if you see that symbol right there, you got some overset text, right? You need to make some changes. All I'm going to do is, because we're just practicing, right? I'm going to get in here and I'm going to delete some of that text. I don't need all that text down there, so I'm just going to get my type tool. I'm going to swipe some of that text. I'm going to delete it, maybe add in a period. If I want to, I can bring my text frame back up here. Boom, right? Zoom out. It's a plus. I don't want to zoom in. I can hold Alt on the keyboard for the alternate version of zoom in. Now I got the minus. I can zoom out. Okay. Let's see how this looks. Woo! Boom. All right. Boom. Guys, now, just for time, again, we're saving time. We're practicing. I'm going to select that. I'm going to hold down Shift on the keyboard. Click that. Click that, click that. So guys, I basically clicked all the elements in that bucket. Guys, that's the same as left clicking and swiping a box over all of it. So click and swipe a box or hold down shift. Now I'm ready to group, object group. Now I wanna copy that group. Now I wanna paste that group. Now I wanna hold down shift and use my arrow keys so I can quickly move that into place. All right, now I'm not holding shift. I'm just using my arrow keys, nudging things into place. So guys, you don't have to create everything from scratch. Build something, copy and paste, and change it up, right? So let me change this up a little bit. Get my type tool, come in here, change that to 3, right? We don't want these colors the same. So let's come in here, let's change these up a little bit. Boom, I can double click on that. Right, double click on that. Oop, are they grouped? Let's see if they're grouped. Object, yeah, they're grouped. So guys, you notice I couldn't change the color of that rectangle because it was grouped. So InDesign recognized it was grouped. I'm gonna ungroup, right? And now I can work with things independently. I wanna change the color of this bucket. Double click, here's my fill color. Double click in there and change it this way. Guys, remember you have color panels, right? If you want to go to your swatches, you can use these colors, right? There's more colors down here, right? You have colors down here, right? Do anything you want. Let's go with the baby blue, right? Guys, you use whatever colors you want. But I don't like that. So I'm going to double click here. I'm going to go in. Maybe I want to stick with this kind of color scheme a little bit. Maybe some greens. Yeah. Lighten that a little bit. right? Then maybe I want to go in to this bucket up here, change that, mix that green, all right? Play with your colors, get the colors to look the way you want, all right? Not too bad, not too bad. Guys, my color scheme isn't great, but again, we're just practicing, right? Now, here's one thing we got to do. They have an image of a student here reading a book, and notice they got some text wrap. You learned about some text wrap in your geometrics training. So let's do that. Let's do some text wrap. All right. So the first thing I got to do is I got to make a content frame. I got to make a content frame where I want that image to go. You make your content frame however you like. Now I got to file place an image in that content frame. File place. I'm looking for the girl with the book. I should have named it with keywords. There's my football field. All right. Where's the girl with the student reading book? See how easy that was for me to find, guys? Make sure you name your files that you save with good keywords that you easily will know what that file is without having to spend time to open up the file. I know this is the file I'm looking for because I named it student reading book. Okay. Now I may want to come up here to my fitting options under object, object fitting. First, I'm going to try fill frame proportionately. Okay, maybe that's not what I want. Maybe I'll try to come to fit content proportionally. That's a little better. All right, guys, now I got to do my text wrap. Okay, if I can remember how to do the text wrap, we got to tell InDesign what we're trying to wrap and around what. So we're trying to wrap around this picture. We need to also select the text. There is a text wrap panel. If I can find it, here it is, text wrap, right? So we got to open our text wrap panel. And then here's all our options. No text wrap. Wrap around bounding box. What's the bounding box? It's that content frame with the image in it. So it's going to wrap around it. This is going to wrap around an object shape. So if you had an object, maybe like a circular shape or something like that. Here is a jump object, so it's not going to show anything on the right or the left. It's going to jump from the top to the bottom. And here's your jump to next column. So in this case, I want to use wrap around bounding box. Boom, look at that, right? Now my text kind of wraps around that image. Guys, you have some options here you can play with if you want, right? See how it's affecting the text? So you get the text to fit the way you want, right? Mess around with this a little bit, right? You got some wrap too. Right side, left side, both right and left sides. Get in here and play around a little bit, right? See what works best for you. All right. Now, guys, let's close that panel. Let's view our artwork. Let's go to screen mode. Let's go to presentation. Presentation mode or Shift W. Now that's not bad, right? I've got a banner up top. Got the name of my newsletter. Got some drop shadows. I got my spring issue and the volume number in the year. I created some buckets, right, with some content. I have some key dates down here. I can clearly see my gutters. I clearly can see things are lined up nice here, right? Things are nice and lined up here, right? That's why we have margins. That's why we have columns and gutters, right? That's why we pull down guides from the rulers, right? Guys, not too bad. That's not a bad sample newsletter. Is it the best newsletter ever? No. Is the color scheme great? Not really. It's not bad practice. So guys, if we can get to this point, then we just need to file export this as a PDF and submit it and get turned in. Then we'll start working on our real actual newsletter. So again, if you have not started thinking about your topic, think about your topic, right? Sports, food, fashion, games. Try to pick something that you have knowledge of. Try to pick something that you can easily gather images for. I prefer you to take your own original images with your cell phones. Take the pictures, save them to your OneDrive. You can file place these images in InDesign from your OneDrive. All original work. All your original intellectual property. All right, guys, let's finish it up here. To get out of presentation mode, I just need to hit escape on the keyboard. Right? I can go up here to view, fit page and window. Right? Now I'm ready to export. Guys, right now it's a .indd file. It's an InDesign file. That's like a .psd, a Photoshop document. That's our native original file where we can get in and make all our changes. But what I want to do is export this out as a PDF, a portable document format. All right, so let's go to File. Let's go down to Export. All right, make sure it's named. Sample Newsletter 1. All right, here's where we decide what file format we want. All right, you should already know JPEGs, Joint Photographic Expert Group. It's a compression file. It's a lossy file. It loses some quality when you compress it. PNGs, Portable Network Graphic. It's also a compression file, but it is lossless. It does not lose quality when you compress it, and it also supports transparency. All right? You'll learn more about an encapsulated PostScript and all these other files later, but we want a Adobe PDF print. Adobe PDF print, right? Save it. Right, guys, here's where you can decide what shows up on your document for the printer. Right? Boom. We have no interactive elements. We have no bookmarks or hyperlinks. We don't have any of that stuff, right? Let's see. I think we're good so far, right? Yeah, we're good. We're good. We don't need to do anything else. Now we're ready to hit export. There is overset text on these pages. Oh, wow, that's cool. Boom, there's my overset text indicator. So I'm going to get my magnifying glass, my zoom tool. Zoom in so that area is easier to see. All right, I'm going to get my selection tool. See how much text I got in there. Not much, I don't need it. It's just placeholder text. Come in here and I'm going to delete it. Boom. All right, there's some more. We got to keep deleting. Keep deleting. All right, if we could thread to another column, but in this case, we're in the far right column. So we're not going to thread to another column. Since we're just practicing and this is just placeholder text, we're fine with this. Thank you, InDesign, for noticing we had overset text. Now we're ready to file. Export. Make sure it's named. Make sure it's a PDF. Make sure you know where it's going to. I don't want it to go to customer service. I want it to go to Digital Design One, right? Save, right? Everything's good. Maybe I want to view the PDF after exporting to see what it looks like. Export. Didn't seem to have any options. No overset text. Now here it displayed my PDF after I opened it. I can go to view. All right, maybe I want to go full screen mode. Guys, not a bad newsletter for never using InDesign before, for never creating a newsletter before. Right? Not too bad, not too bad. All right, guys, get your sample newsletter completed. Export it as a PDF. Please do not turn in your .indd file. Please turn in your PDF file. And then we will on to our projects. All right, we're done. Peace.